There we go, now we should be up and running. Everything's fine. I gotta remember what I did though. It's been so long since I streamed, I had a lot of stuff that was just going on over the last couple weeks. Alright.
Aha, thou return.
Okay, so what do... I don't really want to start transposing at everything yet. Because there is one that I do want to make, and it should be after the next boss fight. I should be able to do it. Now that's really, really loud in my ears. Okay, so back to Farron. Okay, I don't think we put out all the fires yet, so we need to make sure we do that. And then we can get on to the next area in the game. Let's forward, let's go this way. Nope, looks like I've only put out two of the flames. Alright, so now then, where are the other two at? It'd be really helpful if I could remember which two I put out, which two I haven't yet. Or you. Well, in this case, I guess we just kind of go for looking for shinies. Get out of there. Wait for a minute, let my poison meter go down here, because I got an item over there I want to grab. Yeah, that's far enough. The wolf bloodgrass is the item used to improve your covenant alliance. There we go. Improve your covenant alliance within the Farron Hunters. Alright. Everything sounds like it's moving. It freaks me out. I'm going to try to avoid fighting that guy. Though I make no promises. Because there are two other items I do want to get that I'm pretty sure they're both back in that direction. Which kind of stinks. Alright. Hold on. I got a specific item I need to equip. Come here. Take these, dual wield them. Please don't look my way. Because I'm pretty sure this guy is one of the ones who will chase me all the way to the ends of the earth. Oh, jeez, oh, Pete, the other one came. I didn't think he saw me. I'm like 3 minutes into the stream and I've already died once. I'll give you an idea on exactly what I'm expecting out of this one. That island first. Ooh, good, a Titanite shard. That'll be useful. Alright, I'm gonna go get that. Ah, the Nameless Helm. And now I'm poisoned anyway. Super easy to do this in my other file, but that one I had the benefit of a little bit more health, too. Okay, so here's one I haven't put out yet. Didn't think I had. Open sesame. All right, I can finally get out of the poison swamp area for a little bit anyway. There's still a couple of items that I want from the swamp, unfortunately for me, but that's just something I'm gonna have to grab. That's one of those guys. Oh, thank goodness. Ah, dang it. I haven't played in a while, can you tell? At least they didn't jump on me. That's what those ones usually do. End up jumping on you. Oh, but now it's... Oh, not that way. Now, since I'm back here, I'll be really easy to get to the gate, because it's right in front of me. I'll have to come back here a little bit later and find the second scroll, because there's two sorcery scrolls here in the swamp that you're going to want to pick up. Let's go up here. Yep. I need to take you out. That was not what I intended to do. It actually worked out in my favor, so I'm not going to complain. Because that other guy will shout. If he shouts, that riles all the rest of them up, and then they all start flocking you. But I guess I killed him too fast for that. I think I had there for a second, but okay. And... you're not going to let me do this. And you're down. Okay, let me double check on something here first. Okay, my mic, okay. Okay. Alright, let's grab this item real quick. Shriving Stone. Yeah. Okay, so now you can kind of see the swamp down there. And... nah, I'm not gonna do it yet. I'm going to get to the next bonfire before I do what I'm thinking. So it should be a shortcut from that bonfire. Yeah, I'm just going to let you guys fight for right now. Yeah, over here, this is where the next bonfire is. Alright. Yeah, that's good. Because the boss is actually back the other way. But I'm going to go this way first, because I want to get to those items I was talking about. The two sorcery scrolls. Good gosh, you're a pain in the tuchus. got one too. You see over there is one of the large crystal lizards. I'm not going to fight him just yet. Instead, I'm going to come down here and drop through this hole. There we go. And I'm going to pick up these couple of items here. The Atonement spell. And the Hollow Gem. Alright, now then, unless I'm mistaken. But there it is. Okay. If you drop right here, and then hurry back here. No, anti-curse. Do not curse me, do not curse me, do not curse me, do not curse me. Okay, good. Ah, crap. Get out, get out, get out. Please leave me alone. I want to talk about what's down here. Good? Okay, good. Okay, so this message, could this be a planned encounter? Because here's the golden scroll. And it looks like a big mushroom in front of it. You can kind of see a little bunch of little mushrooms around it. And that's because if we look at the golden scroll here, we can learn the arts of Ulysil. So if you guys remember from way back in Dark Souls 1, Ulysil was the place where you went back in time to for the DLC, and you met Elizabeth, who was a giant mushroom. So, yeah, guys, welcome to the Royal Garden of Ulysil. And those are the clothes that the Princess of Ulysil wore when you saved her. Alright, we're going to get back to that bonfire. And you want to pick up... last bonfire. You're going to want to pick up at least one scroll for a NPC that we can pick up in a little bit. Thanks, CBW. I didn't realize you toasted me. But, yeah, you want to pick up the scroll for an NPC we're going to get in a little bit, because he will help you if you have a high enough intelligence, which I do. You need to have an intelligence of 10. But he will leave after you've beaten... He'll leave after you've beaten, I believe, 5 bosses if you don't give him a sorcery scroll. So as long as you have one, you're set. Just not let him leave. That way we can pick up all the sorceries we can. I'm going to let these guys fight each other. Where's the other one? Oh, there he is. Yeah, there's 2 dark wraiths. They can just go at it. Okay. Can I get... you are still down here, so I should be able to fight you. Hoping to do this without drawing the other one in, too. Ah, man. Feels really weird to play this after playing my New Game Plus file. Because that one, I just ripped these guys apart. Aw, you dodged me, you little bugger. There we go. Oh, sweet, I got his armor on the first try. Alright, and you... okay, it looks like they killed the other one already. And come back up over here, because there's actually 2 of them. I don't know why, but my game always seems to lag as soon as I get to this spot. It doesn't really happen too often, but it's always, like, right there. Alright, let's take you out. And then there should, in theory, be only one enemy left. Right there. There we go. And I'm gonna pillage that corpse. Sweet. So the boss is up here. I'm not gonna go in there just yet. I want to try and actually get summoned to fight against the boss so I don't have to use one of my embers. Oh, actually, no. Dang it. Something else I want to do first. Yes, my summon sign disappeared because I disengaged my covenant. There we go. Let's get the warriors on there. And actually... Nah, not you. You. there we go. Alright, now let's retry this. There we go. Golden sign. Much more better. Hopefully that doesn't take too long. If it's taking too long, I'm just going to go ahead and try it myself. Doesn't look like I'm the only person around here. Ah, there we go. We're being summoned. That didn't take too long at all. Hello. I don't really know what your name is supposed to be. I see that. You're poisoned. Alright, let's go here. The Abyss Watchers. This is actually a pretty fun boss fight. If you're really good, you can parry this guy. I'm not that good, so don't ask me to do it. The other ones should be popping in right now. So you can see there's actually another one here. Actually, there's two more here now. And you can actually get them to fight each other, which is always rather fun to do. If you can pull it off. However, the one I'm locked onto, or the one without a health bar, is the one that you need to defeat. See, the other two are fighting each other. And that is one strategy for doing this, is just to keep making them all fight each other until they're low enough on health that you can just, like, wild shot them. Oh, good, there we go. We're on to the second phase. So now here in the second phase, I'm going to go ahead and quick heal. There is... Oh, you got a backstab in on him. Nice. There is only one. He's going to be the only one to show up. But you can see his attacks now all have fire, and they do have an extended range. Come back here, you. Back up. Come on. Ah, shoot. I was too far over and the flames got me. Oh, good luck to you. Dang it. Alright, let's try that again. There we go. That's right around here. I think I've gotten all the items that are up here. It's been a very long time, I feel, since I've really played Dark Souls. It's been a really long time since I feel like I've streamed. That's just been... had a couple of trips that I took and did a lot of stuff. Traveled out of state both times, so I was... couldn't really stop and stream. But it's okay. I mean, I'm still having fun. Got... come on. Didn't take that long for me to get summoned last time. Maybe I need to put my sign down by the bonfire. That's usually the two places where people drop summon signs for this boss. It's usually either up here or down by the bonfire on the other side. Let's go ahead back and just drop it back here. Sometimes it's better to drop them by the bonfire because then you also get the, you also get helping people along the way. So it's sometimes a little bit easier to do it back there. Plus, I get to kill some stuff while I'm waiting. There we go. I was afraid he was gonna hit me. That would not have been good. I almost got enough souls to level up. Didn't really look like they had shards flying anywhere. That was sad. And come on, where is everybody? Is no one gonna summon me? Yeah, I guess we're doing this my way. Okay, let's use this. And I'm not going to see any signs because mine's down, so let's go ahead and cancel mine. And I want to summon you. The Landor Pershed. It's an NPC summon, but... let's see, are you going to teach it? Yep, there we go. And I can learn the dual bow from summoning him. That makes it more fun. Come along. Then, let's get headed straight out of here. And we're gonna make a dash. Straight to the boss fight. Hopefully we beat him, because once you beat him, you can transpose his soul into the weapon I want to use. If for no other reason than it's just a lot of fun to use it. There you are. What were you doing back there? All the entertainment's up here. They're going to keep moving up, so I'm going to as well. Really? You're going to use that on him now? big old magic attack. There we go. Yeah, save those. We're gonna need them here in a minute. Come here, boys. Stop dodging. Oh, that could have gone better. Horns down. Ah, oh, dang it, I thought I was out of the reach. Come on, do it again. Didn't work out quite the way that I thought it would, but I'm willing to accept it. Oh, my first aid stinks. Alright, let's get a refill on my mana. And collect your stuff. Good, another Titanite shard. Now alright. Blackhand Godheart. Another NPC summon. I haven't really seen any players. Maybe they're just not on today. Or they're probably all on, like, New Game Plus 7 type of a deal. Yes. And thank you for teaching that. That's one of my favorite gestures in the game. I'm gonna go ahead. I don't need you. I want that one. That one. By my sword, sir. Alright, let's go ahead and try and take this guy on. Except with me, I'm gonna make you watch the whole cutscene at the start. Well, that was violent. And actually, if you listen before you come in here, you can actually hear the sounds of battle, like swords clashing.
The Legion.
All right, let's do this thing. That was a bad dodge to start out with. Can I get it? Yes, I got the backstab in. Oh, wow, that did not last long. Come darn it, I am not having any luck today against this guy. But I really want to beat him because he's got the item I want. And I'm going to drop my sign down here again. See if maybe I can get lucky. If not, I'm just going to have to... try and just level up, get some more health and stats. Before I kill you! Alright, let's see where we end up this time. I need to get some more sunlight medals anyway. Nikki. Hello. Let's go. Hopefully we just don't have the same problem I had before when I was playing. Last time I was playing, I got summoned to I got summoned as a moon bro, and I ended up... we did manage to kill one of the invaders, but I was lagging so much on it that I was nowhere near this guy's attacks, and he was hitting me. I couldn't see. What I was doing at that point anyway. Okay, he wants to just go straight up and into the boss area. Focus on the only one that matters. Oop. There we go. Don't go in there. Don't. Dude. You know. I know why they do it. To try, you know, get the boss out of the way. But it's just one of those things like, you know, if you can get three of them to just start beating on each other, just let them beat on each other. Sure, the boss isn't going to lose that much health, but... I mean, come on, man. Nice job. Not gonna make that mistake twice. I'm gonna try not to. Come here, you little. Oh, we won. There we go. So now we got the Ember and the Sunlight Medal. And hopefully we can find ourselves a human player. Alright, yep, there we go. That restores my Ember. Alright, is there anybody here? Ah, there's somebody. Okay, I'll summon somebody who wants to name himself Abyss Watcher. Hooray for being a warrior of the sun. Hello, Abyss Watcher. Let's go, shall we? Don't really see too many of the mound builders signs down anymore. Which I wouldn't really suspect that you would once the initial parts of the game wore off, because, well, they can't help you, let's all be honest here. I don't think too many people want to summon somebody who can also kill you once you reach the boss room. It was a very interesting, way to play it, but I don't think it would work out super great in the long run. Alright, let's get in here. You stabbed him. I want to get my soul back. There we go. Nope. None of that from you. I remember what having a greatsword used to be like. I'll have it again soon. I do believe my stats are correct for the weapon I want in this fight. Holy shnikes. I haven't seen that happen in a long time. Alright, there we go. On to stage two. You're gonna watch the whole cutscene. That's just the way I do my content. Plus, I kinda like how this one's done. Versus the other Lords of Cinder. Alright. Let's do this now, then. This guy's good. Or maybe I'm just lagging on him. I'm willing to bet that's at least part of the reason, because that last time he hit him, he wasn't even anywhere close. That could have been a lot worse. Okay, I need to get away. I need to heal. I can take one more. Just because we're just about done here. So we get the Lord, Cinders of a Lord, Soul of the Blood of the Wolf, and a Sunlight Medal for him. Ah, he's gone. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and light the bonfire. Now let's get out of here. Back to Firelink so we can transpose this soul. And possibly upgrade my stats. I think they're at the right ones, but I'm never sure with this one. It's not a weapon that I've really used before. Oh, you're here right now. Huh?
Ah. I know you. Been some time. I just dropped in to see how she's getting on. Now, what are you playing at with this circus? This cesspool of doddering old folk and degenerates. Couldn't be better. She must fit in perfectly here.
I feel like you're trying to say something about her or about my crew. I'm not 100% sure
this
which.
This place is a good note for
Okay, that's all you're going to say. I thought I talked to you before.
Hello again. I have since heard a great deal about you.
Woohoo!
For one, that you are most gentle of heart. I, too, am bound by duty, but can offer you my sign. I hear that cordial intrusion lays the path to embers. If I can be of help, by all means, do call upon me. Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
Yay. Oh, she gives me the dark moon loyalty.
If you require a blessing.
Okay, now she'll just show up for certain boss fights. More importantly, as long as you keep her alive, you can do her questline. First, blah 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 on you. Okay, so the blood of the wolf soul you can transpose into one of two weapons. You can either get the Wolf Knight Greatsword, which is basically Artorias's sword from the first Dark Souls game, or you can get the Farron Greatsword, which is the weapons that the I need 18 strength. Okay, weapon that the Abyss Watchers were just using, and that's the one I want. Alright, I need more strength to use it.
Welcome home, speak. Very well, then tuck Haken.
Alright, I got, I think, 16? Yep. But there we go, okay. So that's two levels on that. And. What else do I want to improve here? I got two more levels to play with. The question is, what do I want to be able to use later on in the game? I'm gonna have that. Alright, I'm gonna up my health twice, because that's one of the problems I've been having right now.
Farewell, Ash May the Flame.
Okay, so now we have the ability to use it, so let's take a look. There it is. I am going to have to try and drop some other stuff, though. Oh, man, I'm still just over. Alright, do I have anything lighter? I really do not want to wear those. Sure, let's wear the Master Gloves right now. Okay, so here we go. This is the weapon we're going to be using throughout the game. It's got a pretty basic, normal attacks. But the reason why you have a lot of fun with this weapon is once you go to two-handing, you see you bust out the dagger there. Still doesn't seem that abnormal. And really, just doing that isn't that weird. But if you go to the other side, there's your parry. So you can parry using it, or you can do what my buddy and I always do. You can breakdance. Ah, that's going to be a lot of fun. I'm going to be doing that so many times. Alright, let's see here. I think I can improve it at least once. I don't think I have... No Estus Shards. So... Oh, nope, that's not what I want. Ah, dang it. I don't have any Titanic skills? I thought I had one by now.
Pretty, be careful.
Oh well. Still awesome. So now that we have busted him out, we can. Actually, you should have new dialogue now.
At the foot of Lothric Castle, An old path still runs below the tower in the undead settlement. It was used to transport sacrifices to the Cathedral of the Deep, if you...
Yeah, well, that's where we're going to next, the Cathedral of the Deep. That's Yorm's. This one is, yep. So here's the Abyss Watchers. So what we can do now is... I want to look at the item description on it first. Lords not return to the thrones, let them return as cinders. Swore upon their shared wolf's blood and also serve the mandate of lords. So now that we have the cinders, we can offer it. And that just basically puts some relic of the Lord of Cinder there on their throne. For a lot of it, it's skulls. I won't deny that.
You haven't given up yet. Then you're a brasher lad than I thought. You can make better use of this.
And a heavy gem. That's sweet.
I don't need it. Not now I've flown the coop. The undead legion of Farron is a caravan of undead, sworn by wolf's blood to contain the abyss. The legion will bury a kingdom. Joyous bunch, really. Gaining admission to the legion inside even a kind.
I've already done all that. Okay, now let's get out of here. So now we need to go to... I need to back up a little bit here. Where? What's the best spot to do this from? I don't really want to go down that one just yet. Alright, let's do this from the Crucifixion Woods. That's as close as I think I've gotten at this point. So now we're going to go the other way than we basically did. Way, way back in the day. We are going to... I got summon signs up here. That's a little bit weird. Okay, so way back when we did this before, we went out across the water. This time we're actually going to go back into the ruins behind us here. I get invaded. That hasn't happened in a while either. Really use my chloroform. I was afraid he was gonna do that. He got me on the backstab wall. I was taking out the other guys. Come here, you little bugger. So the experienced players are pretty good at countering the Farron Greatsword's natural special abilities. But it's not super easy, because it does do, like, with all the up and down and twists and turns, it does make it a lot harder to know exactly when to dodge, when to move. Come here, you little bugger. Pass, I'm not gonna get the last one on him. Oh, I thought I was out of the way of that one. Suppose after this fight's done, I should put my... Oh, man. I'm gonna be using this. I really need to increase my stamina. Well, I'm giving just as well as I'm taking at this point, I think. He's probably actually realized by now. My greatest weakness is my stamina at this point. He isn't trying to heal, so I think he's out of Estus. Got him. And unto you, sir, I offer my Legion etiquette. You were a good fighter. He was. That was a pretty good fight. I like having those kind of like PvP battles where it's not completely one-sided and just walloped beyond belief, where you're just getting one like nothing you do is doing anything to them. Okay. But I have a couple of things I am going to need to improve. I'm going to need to get more stamina, which I haven't really had to worry about at this point. Okay, good. I didn't get the rest of them to wake up. My stamina, and I'm gonna have to improve my equip load. Yeah, neither one of those will be super difficult to do. Okay, I think that should be everything in this room. I already picked up a lot of stuff. Alright, now let's do it. Oh, I have to go through here first, don't I? There we go. Great for taking down guys' shields. Alright, let's go back here. Because I do not believe I have picked this guy up yet. Here we go.
Well, this is unexpected. I don't often have visitors.
This is my study that you've happened upon.
Really?
If you haven't any business,
you have a really weird place for your study.
To get back to.
So, you can ask to learn sorceries from him.
How intriguing. Very well.
And
indeed, I am a sorcerer.
If you don't have at least 10 intelligence, he will refuse to, and he'll just stay here.
Champion demands service.
And if you have a ring that increases your intelligence, he'll...
Clearly you're not that sort.
As long as your intelligence is above 10, at this point, he will go ahead and leave. Even if you have a ring used to increase it, if you take it off, he doesn't, like, deny teaching you anything.
Well?
Yes.
Very well. You're no fool. I am
Blah, blah. Orbeck of Vinheim.
We will,
blah, 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 blah. He just talks. So basically, the promises that I had to make there was the promise that I would give him scrolls. And obviously, you guys have already seen, I already picked up one scroll. So I've already fulfilled my part of the bargain. Now, obviously, there are more scrolls in the game. And I will be picking those ones up as well. I am not falling down there because bad things happen if I fall down there. But the more scrolls you give him, the better sorceries you can learn. Ulysil's scroll is pretty good, but it does a lot more healing, or focuses more on like healing and restoration magics than it does offensive magic. So if you want to learn the better offensive magics, you definitely need to pick up. Holy shnikes. Need to learn to pick up some of the other scrolls. There you are. I need to take that one out. Whew. That actually made me a little bit nervous there. Yeah, I hate the fact that one of those guys knows Soul Spear. But it's not... Obviously, it's not too hard to take him out. Okay. Up here, there should be at least an NPC summon. I know there was one. There's supposed to be an NPC summon around here somewhere, because there's another boss up there, and he's not super difficult. But I don't really want to, like, charge in just yet. And that's basically a warning about that. Eh. Maybe I went too far on the other hand. You can do this one a lot earlier, so it might be that I went too far by killing the Abyss Watchers. Oh well, I'll just summon this guy then. Servers are slow today. I welcome you with a toast, so. Alright, in we shall go. So in here is the Crystal Sage. And the Crystal Sage on their own is not that tough of a boss fight. Probably the most difficult thing, if you want to call that, about this boss fight is the disappearance and reappearance. Okay, there you are. So, the Crystal Sage will disappear and reappear at different points around the arena. And eventually, they will start making copies of himself. There, okay, there you are. Now, the way you can tell which one is the one you need to attack is the one that you need to attack will always have purple. It'll have the purple magic, like you can kind of see there, the purple glow. The copies will have blue magic. Or blue crystal sorceries. There you are. Also great for dodging sorceries. Well, that hurt like a dickens. I am really gonna need to get some more HP. Okay. You're the real one. Jeez, oh, geez, what the heck's going on with the boss today? Probably also doesn't help that I'm not doing nearly as much damage as I am used to doing in boss fights. Blue, purple. Oh, come on, really? Where are you at? There's the purple. Oh, and Gideon got in the last strike. But there we go. And the soul of the Crystal Sage. By my sword, sir. Thank you. And another Sunlight Metal. Let's go ahead and light this bonfire, and then we'll move onwards. Actually, I'm going to rest at it, because I am completely out of Estus flasks. Because I am just taking damage up the wazoo. Excuse me. And I don't want to spend my souls just yet, because I want to save and buy a key. And that key is going to cost me 20,000 souls. Alright, now what you want to do is drop down here. And take this one out. Then let's go ahead and drop down here. Yes, revenge. But first... and take out that one. Get another Twinkling Titanite. Over here, you can get a back attack going in there, but I'm going to wait just a minute, because I think... is there another item up here? I felt like there was something else up here. Oh no, you can get a drop attack on this guy if you want to, which I do. He's a piece. I'm gonna die right here. Some of these death animations just take way too long. You can see there, that's what that spell I picked up earlier in the stream does. I can see where it could be useful, but I am just not gonna use that. I really need to start doing more damage. Okay, more damage and more defense. Both of those will come in time. I need to get my souls back too, unfortunately. Oh, at least I'm not the only one who's died there. My souls. And I'm gonna fall down here. Alright, now I'm going to see. I heard him coming. Okay, that's weird. Get me this time. I got my souls. I'm getting out of here. I don't think they'll chase me across the bridge. At least that's what I'm hoping. Because over here, I have to deal with two NPC enemies. There's the first one. Now you're throwing stuff at me? Come on. There we go, you're down. 1,500 souls, that's pretty good. And then we get pick up the Paladin Ashes from down here. Which? Well-worn Paladin who sought the Cathedral of the Deep with this Shrine Maiden will prepare new items. Paladin paid quite a price for his headstrong justice. Yeah, I'd agree with that. Okay, now the other one should be around here somewhere. distinctly remember there being two of them. Okay, look. Get off the beaten path a little ways, and we can pick up an item at the top of this little pathway. There we go. And now we get the Crest Shield. There you are. So the Crest Shield, here we go, is a lot better, you can see, than the shield I'm currently using, and weighs the same amount. Let's go ahead and get that equipped on there. We're going to get a quick heal in. There are multiple forms of the Crest Shield in this game. Ooh, nice. In the original Dark Souls game, there were two Crest Shields. You're not getting at that. There was the Dragon Crest Shield, which you could get early game, as long as you picked up the Master Key. And then there was the Crest Shield that you could get from Oscar the second time you went to the Asylum. For here, this one, you know, this is the same design as the Crest Shield we get from Oscar. I'm not 100% sure if it has the same stats or not. Wouldn't surprise me if it did. But the major change that they've made with the Crest Shields in this game, there's, I think, four at least. I did not want to get stuck there. There's at least four, I believe. And they have slightly better defense against a particular secondary ability. Like, they all have 100% physical blockage. But the Dragon Crest Shield is better at blocking fire damage. The Crest Shield, the one I have now, is better at blocking magic. And I don't remember what the other two have exactly. The second one, or the last one we're going to pick up, I'm not going to tell you what it can do. Because it's a lot of fun once we get it. Okay, I'm going to go back and rest at the bonfire quick. Starting to run low on my Estus flasks again. And that's frustrating. And I've also picked what ending I'm going to go for during this one. So I was trying to debate it about which ending exactly I wanted to, you know, show you guys. And the thing is, it's kind of like there's... I haven't done a Usurper of the Flame ending yet, and I consider doing that one on here. But when I looked up what you need to do in order to get that ending, there's just a lot of... That's an ending you have to do from very early on, with the idea that you want to do that ending. And it's not that it's a bad ending, but it's just I don't want to do that one on stream, because then I have to get rid of doing all these... Son of a foops. That dog just glitched his way up to me. I don't want to do that one on stream, because then I have to basically sacrifice all these other side quests and skills that I also want to do on stream. Oh, come on. One of the reasons why I don't like the dogs in this game. Fly back so easily that trying to use my spin attack on them doesn't really work. There we go. I think there's only two more dogs left. And a bunch of archers. Look, two dogs, two archers. Alright, should be safe from the archers in that spot. There we go. Arrows in my wrist, arrows in my shoulder, arrow in my thigh. Actually, to my surprise, they missed my knee. We're almost to the next bonfire, though, so... go ahead and use my last Estus flask here. There should just be one enemy between me and it, and he is semi-suicidal. Stay away from me. I win. Yeah, there's a couple of enemies here in the cathedral, and a couple other places too, that stab themselves with their sword and ignite, and then try and chase you down. Yeah, they're very easy to dodge as long as you can see it coming. Looks like somebody's here waiting. Alright, let's go ahead and rest up at this thing. Alright, let's go for it. We got a lot of enemies in this area. This is kind of a fun area, too. You could come here before... yeah, he's not there yet. Yet being the key word. You could come here before you go do the Abyss Watchers. So that was hilarious and easy. But if you do everything here, and I'm not even going to do everything here at this point. Oh, good, an Estus Shard. Then you lose out on... you can lose out, I guess I should say, on a side quest, or one of the NPC quests. And now up here, we run into zombies. It's a very strange thing to think about in a game that is essentially full of zombies. And these guys will all respawn. Like, you're not going to run out of enemies in this graveyard. You're just not going to. And let's pick up the Astora Greatsword. What else have we got in here? This is also... there's also a lot of, like, nooks and crannies back in here. It's entirely another way to go, too, but if you go that way, you'll eventually have to come back up here and go this way. That's why I'm going to go this way first. You can see down there, there's a bunch of enemies. Throw you down there with them. Because this one will lead right over here. And in Dark Souls, if it looks like a trap, and you think it's a trap, it's probably a trap. So let's go, pick up these, and we're going to get out of here. Because this is not a place you want to get stuck. Especially the two that came out of the ground there. Because, and there should be one... actually, you know what? I'm pretty sure I'm heading the wrong direction. Should be... you know what? I'm just gonna fall. So we'll be going down there in a little bit. Just not quite a second. There's the bridge I was looking for, and you can kind of see that one guy who's walking across the bridge. It seems to have something extra on him. They can be a little bit of a pain because they don't just do you damage. Now, that would be way too easy. Dang it. Now I've got it. None of that from you. Alright, I've got a couple more seconds. Okay, you see my bleed bar down there is increasing. I got to go. I never picked it up. Dang it, I'm an idiot. Dang it. I need you. Use. Shrine. Oh, that was stupid of me. Okay, here we go. Not here for you. Let me talk to you.
Oh, how many?
Now first, let's give you the Paladin Ashes.
Let this I only.
And let's get... you can also buy the Legion armor here now if you want to. There you are. I need a torch. And I need a torch very, very badly. You see, now she sells Titanite shards. And let me actually sell off... They're not going to give me anything for it, but I'm not keeping those in my inventory.
Ashen one.
Yeah, you want to have a torch and not be stupid, like I was. Because if you get hit by those guys, then they basically put leeches on your body, and you'll just continually build up bleed resistance, unless you either use a red... unless you use a red moss, or if you have fire, then they will just jump right off of you. So as long as you have the torch, just pull the torch out. Boom, you're done. There we go, I'm just going to get this now. Okay, now I have the 20,000. I'm going to buy this tower key.
Ashen one.
Which will allow me access to... Oop, not that way. This way. Access to the tower behind Firelink, which actually I also need to check this corpse over here. And I get a seed of the giant tree. The seed will fall if you do get invaded in your game. I'm not sure if it works if you're in somebody else's game and they get invaded. But the seed of the giant tree is... It can be useful. Basically, if you use it, enemies in the area will attack whoever it is that has invaded you. So usually they're, you know, they're free to just kind of roam around while they look for you. But if you use that, then the enemies will attack them, and all of a sudden they have the same, basically the same weakness you do. And you can kind of sit back and wait, see what happens, do whatever you want. I think I've used one before just because I could not find the enemy. So if we come up here to the top, yeah, we get a Firekeeper soul. Let's go ahead and look at the description on that. Firekeeper preserves the bonfire and serves its champion. She is said to have soothed and accepted the dark sigil, which has tainted her soul, and yet her soul will one day embed itself in the bosom of another Firekeeper. So with this Firekeeper soul, what you can do is you can give it to... Excuse me. You can give it to the Firekeeper there in the shrine, and she will be able to cure your dark sigils if you don't want to look like me. All beef jerkied. Now there are items down there. I'm not going to go get those yet. I'm going to go over here first. And we're going to fall down here in the middle. There we go. So that we can talk to this guy.
You. Me, Bicklebee. Me. Bumperum.
Picklebee, who is our friend in this game. So, he also, you can drop different items and get newer ones. Like, if I leave this here.
Bumperum.
Yep. And I pick up the armor of the sun. the sun. Choice attire for the singular night of sunlight from a previous age. I wonder who that was. But it also makes me too heavy. I don't quite yet have the ring. I believe I can get something if I drop one of these as well. Yep. And, oh, sweet, I got a Titanite chunk for dropping that. And there's a whole list of just different items you can get. Let's kick this ladder so we don't have to come up here the other way again. But there's a couple other items that we can actually get while we're here. So now, obviously, there's that crystal lizard. But if you run around here, the lower ceiling portion, and come all the way around to the front. Actually, no, there's another item around to the side. We'll get back to this one here in a second. Yeah, let's pick this one up. The Homeward Bone. 3 more of them. That's nice. Alright, here is... There. The other ones I was talking about. So you come in here, and you can see we are now on the rafters above the main portion of the shrine. And we want to walk carefully here. This would not bode well. And you can see... Yeah. We're actually underneath his nest, so you can also do the drop items here and pick up the new ones. So you don't always have to go all the way up to the top of the shrine. But if you come this way... Yep. This is an illusionary wall. And you can come back through here. This is behind where you've been able to get to at this point. And you can pick up this little beauty, which I will be using quite often. The Covetous Silver Serpent Ring. Let's go ahead and get that equipped on instead of you. The Covetous Silver Serpent Ring will yield, I believe it's 10% more souls from the defeated enemies, which is very, very useful when you're trying to collect souls. And I'm gonna take a wandering look around here. What do you have to say?
Oh, hello, and in one piece.
And he's got some decent stuff, but I'm not gonna buy anything.
Goodbye.
From you. Alright, so now, because we haven't talked to these guys in a while, let's go over and see everybody. What do I have from you? And I'm not going to buy any of these just yet. I could reinforce my Pyromancy Flame, but I'm not going to do that one just yet either. And now Orbeck of Vinheim.
Oh, you're back.
Vinheim. I just like saying Vinheim.
Again, I'm Orbeck. Let us begin with the basics. The ideals, you can...
No, I don't want to. So he has all of these other spells. I'm going to go ahead. No, wait, I already have Spook, don't I? Yes, I do. Forgot this class starts with Spook. So you can have all of these other ones that are pretty good. However, things like any weapon that's going to reinforce my sword is not going to be useful because you cannot reinforce the Faerun Greatsword. But we have our scroll here, so let's go ahead and give this to him so that he won't leave us later.
It's from Ulysseal, an ancient land of golden sorceries.
Woohoo!
Not even the Dragon School possesses such a long-lost scroll.
I'm very sneaky.
But the Xanthus scholars say, with their ridiculous headwear,
they would simply slaver over this find.
So now, once you give that to him, you can learn the Pestilent Mercury that eats away at HP. Light Repair, which is not as big of a deal in this game as it was in some other ones. Hidden Weapon, which can be useful. Hidden Body. And the Twisted Wall of Light, which allows you to deflect magic. Now, they're all pretty good.
It is folly to claim lives recklessly, Fred. No matter the victim's stature, every kill, even as I bloodied my hands. Come again.
He has a long history with, he has a very, very long history with the School of Yunheim and what he's actually done with his life. Alright, you.
Champion, do you wish to hear a tale?
What do you have? You still have all the basics. What is this? No.
Have a pleasant, I pray for.
We're not giving you that. That's the dark one. You can give it to her, technically, if you want to. But if you want her to have, like, the quote-unquote good ending, you can't buy any of the sorceries that she can that she'll be able to teach you from it. Well, or her good ending to her story.
To see what needs me.
All right. Smithing? Nothing. Reinforcement? Yes. Reinforce my Estus Flask twice. Alright, I'm gonna keep it like that too. So I am going to need a lot of work on this character. Alright, what do I have right now? I'm not doing too bad with some of these. Alright, let's go ahead and head back to the Cleansing Chapel in the Cathedral of the Deep. Now that we've done most of our stuff here, I still haven't gone to the bottom of the tower, but I'll save that for just a little bit longer. Alright, I'm going to take the bottom path this time. Hopefully that doesn't come back to bite me. I don't suppose you're here yet. Nope. In time. Nice try. But I'm still faster. With a lot more spinniness. And you're down. Okay, so if you want to take the low path, you come over this way. And this will allow us to fall down here. And then down here into the water. So now, the first thing you'll notice is this enemy. It's right up there. There's two of them. I am not fighting two of them together right now. He also can give you leeches. But he's also very, very fun to hit with fire. Come on, hit him. There he goes, because he freaks out. Alright, pop out that, and then all the leeches fall off of me. And my bleed meter starts going back down again. Very useful. I'm much, much happier with it doing that. Okay, we've got a crystal lizard over there that we're going to have to deal with. Pick up that titanite shard first. Okay. Alright, let's do this thing. It's been a very long time since I fought one of you in this file. Not doing too bad. None of that. Oh, I thought I dodged early enough to get out of the way of that. That's the upside to actually using this sword. With the spin can also help you dodge some attacks. Some, not all. Come on. Yes! There we go. There, now I've got a Titanite scale. Alright, good. So now we can improve our little blade. You're not going anywhere. You're gonna give me something. Another twinkling. They give a lot of twinkling Titanites from crystal lizards in this game. And another Titanite shard. We're just getting Titanite galore back here, aren't we? Okay, so what else is back here? I'm trying to remember all the items and everything that's around here. Should be, there's a crystal lizard right there. Okay. Thought he wasn't dead yet. I thought there was, another enemy around here. I guess I got that wrong. So I know there's one down here. Because there's the other one of these little buggers. I don't remember there being two of you, though. This will make things more difficult. Holy shnikes. Come on, come here. Out of the way of that one. And you're done. And no more leeches. It's good, because I'm out of Estus. Okay, there should be one last item to pick up down here. Actually, I think there's another one. I take that back. Let's go ahead and pick up the Saint Tree Bellvine, which is a catalyst for using miracles. Now we've done that full circle. I'm gonna take a look and see at the last one. Because I think I'm gonna try a slightly different tactic than what I've been doing. If it's the enemy, I think it is. You can come back down here. Yep, okay, you're here. So let me go ahead and equip my Pyromancy Flame. And we're going to throw fireballs at you. That's much more effective. I should have been doing that from the beginning. And a poison bite ring. Useful. Back in the swamp. Poison bite ring increases your resistance to poison. Really kind of wish I would have had that back in the swamp instead of out here. Alright, fall down here. And this just takes us back into the cleansing chapel. Okay. Oh, there's an item. I don't remember there being an item over there. Yep, learned something new. Ah, the notched whip. That can be a lot of fun, too. But, I think I'm just going to go ahead and end off the stream here, guys. So, next week, I guess we'll be going through the rest of the Cathedral of the Deep and taking on we'll get the Pope Clothes. That's what we call them here. We call them the Pope Clothes. So, thank you everybody who came by and watched, and I will hopefully see you guys next week.